What's up people, welcome to Programming Career. In this quick tutorial, I'm going to talk about two different adaptive bitrate streaming protocol, MPEG-DASH and HTTP live streaming or HLS. These two protocol are most popular adaptive bitrate streaming protocol in 2021, and I will talk about these two protocol one by one and compare them with some practical example, which one to choose in which situation. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, we have to understand what is adaptive bitrate streaming protocol is. So the adaptive bitrate streaming protocol works by determining the bandwidth or internet speed of the client or the media player, so that it can decide which type of video, which quality of video need to be played. For example, in YouTube, when our internet speed is very high, it automatically select the 4K video or 1080p video. But when our internet speed is low, then it automatically select 240p or 360p video. So YouTube is a clear example of adaptive bitrate streaming. YouTube uses their customized protocol, but the idea is almost same. But publicly available two more popular adaptive bitrate streaming protocol is MPEG-DASH and HLS. HLS or HTTP live streaming is developed by Apple, and this protocol supports in almost all kind of devices, including iOS devices and Android devices. But MPEG-DASH, which was developed later and made open source, is not supported in native iOS browser, that means in Safari. So if you want to make a video streaming app or video streaming website or something like that, if you use Dash, then it will not be supported on a Safari browser in iPhone, Tab and Apple TV. So this will minimize a huge audience. But in other cases, HLS and Dash is pretty similar. Both protocol are almost same, but they have some technical differences which I'll come later. But things that come when you decide which protocol to choose, then you have to consider that even though Dash is open source, but it is not natively supported in iOS devices in Safari browser. Excluding that, both protocol deliver a good quality of streaming. There is no much difference between the two. Both support 4K video and both offer similar type of latency. Technically, the core difference between HLS and Dash is that the manifest file is different. Dash uses XML based manifest file, where HLS uses a M3U8 playlist file. So I will use FFmpeg to practically show the differences in manifest file for HLS and Dash. So to do that, I have placed a video file in my Tomcat server. One folder is Dash, one folder is HLS, and both folder containing a sample video named classroom, and I will use FFmpeg in this directory to generate the master playlist file for both HLS and Dash. Here is the command. This is the Dash command, generate the master playlist file. Here input is classroom.mp4, and I am mapping the video part of the input and copying the codec and generating two different variation. One is 800 kbps bitrate and another is 300 kbps bitrate. So if the internet speed is low, it will select 300 kbps bitrate video. So the manifest file will be classroom_manifest.mpd, which is an XML file. Dash uses an XML file. So I'm copying this command, and the classroom.mp4 file is located in this directory, Dash directory. So I'm opening my terminal and pasting this command. So this one started processing. The video is very short, so it will finish very shortly. And another one is HLS. And I'm also copying this HLS command. Here the command is pretty similar. I have mapped the video part of the input with two different variables, and other necessary values are passed in the parameter. So I'm copying this command too. This one has completed processing, and here is the things that started processing. So these files are newly generated. This one is old. I'm deleting this file. And I'm going to HLS folder, here classroom.mp4 file, only one file. I'm opening terminal here. And again, pasting the HLS command here. The processing is about to finish. Yes, both HLS and dash processing is done with FFmpeg. I have shared the command to process in the description of this video and deleted the main input file. So here, if I compare both manifest file, I'm first going to the dashed manifest file, which is classroom_manifest.mpd, and opening it with notepad. You can see that this is a XML file. Here the reference of stream 0 and stream 1, and the references of bandwidth, when the bandwidth is higher, then this one, when the bandwidth is lower, then this one. You can decide which bandwidth you want to set. If you want to set a variation of 6 or 7 different bandwidths, you can also do that. So this one is the manifest file for MPEG-DASH, an example manifest file, and I'm going to the manifest file for HLS and opening this on my notepad++. So this is the HLS manifest file, which is very short, and the file extension is .m3wit. This is basically referring to another manifest file for different variation, but in dash one single XML file is designed. So this is the protocol guidelines as Apple designed it. So I'm going to this directory to see what is going on here. classroom_800k/index.m3wit. So where is the index file? I'm opening this on my notepad++. Here the HLS version is 4 and single file is used, and ext bitrate tag is used to decide which segment of the video, means the TS file, will be played. So here is the difference. And another variation of this HLS manifest file is this one. This one is also pretty similar, but referring to two different transport stream file. So that's all. HLS and dash both offer pretty similar kind of functionality, and the main differences is in manifest file, and both support 4K video, and Apple already announced that HLS can be used for fragmented MP4. That means if you have videos you want to support in both Apple and iOS's, then you can choose the manifest file for the same segments. Now to test the manifest file generated with FFmpeg, this classroom_manifest.mpd and classroom_manifest.m3ewit file. I've hosted those files on my Tomcat server, and this is the URL of my server for those files. We know that both MPT and M3Wit are text files, so I will try to access those videos with this MPT file. So I'm copying this URL for dash and going to my Firefox browser here. By default, HLS and dash video are not supported in browser. You have to use a MSE media player, media source extension based media player. So here I am using a Firefox add-on. You can also use it on Chrome or Microsoft Edge. Name is native MPEG-DASH plus HLS playback. This is basically a media source extension based player. So I've already installed that, and I'm pasting the URL for dash on my browser, and the video is playing. And again, if I copy the file path of HLS, then this file also being played. Now if I disable this extension and paste the URL, as you can see, a manifest file, M3Wit file, is being downloaded. Again, if I enable this extension, then this can play the video. So the final recap is that both HLS and dash has their advantages and disadvantages. Dash has some more featured than HLS, but dash doesn't provide iOS support, which include a large number of audience. If the feature you need is available in HLS, then you can go for HLS protocol. And let me know what you think about it. If you have any idea or any question, you can put a comment down below. All the best for your next video streaming project.